Chess is one of the oldest game in the world. It is a thrilling game of strategy and tactics, and hence it is seen as a symbol of intelligence. Chess is easy to learn and can be played by any age group. As you can see on the screen, chess is played on an 8x8 board with 64 squares and 32 pieces. In chess, the 8 rows are called as ranks, with an indication of a number to each row from 1 to 8. The 8 columns are called as files, with an indication of an alphabet for each column from A to H. By convention, the 64 squares alternate in color and are referred to as light and dark squares. The main motive of the game is to checkmate the king. I will discuss more about checkmate later in this video. Let us now see how to set up the board. Always remember, the light square should be on your right. Pawns are kept on the second rank for white and seventh rank for black. Rooks are placed on the corners. Knights are placed to the side of rooks. Then the bishops are placed to the side of knights. Queens are placed on the matching square. The white queen on white square. The black queen on black square. At last, place your king.
So to start, let's meet the pawns. Pawns are very powerful when working together. Pawns can only move one square forward at a time. But if it's their first move, they can choose to move one or two squares forward. Pawns can choose to move one or two squares only on their first move. On all other moves, they can only move one square forward. Pawns can only capture the enemy pieces one square diagonally. Pawns are the only piece in chess which cannot move or capture any pieces backwards. They also cannot jump over other pieces. As they cannot capture a piece which is in front, they can be easily blocked by other pieces to stop their advancement. In 15th century, a new rule for pawn was introduced, which is called as en passant or en passant. It is a special pawn capture that can only occur immediately after the enemy pawn makes a move of two squares from its starting square. Let's assume you have white pieces and you have moved your pawn from e4 to e5. The enemy has moved his pawn two squares forward. For en passant, the pawn should be parallel to each other. It is as simple as assuming that the enemy pawn has moved only one square and we are capturing that pawn one square diagonally. Now let's see what happens if the pawn reaches the last rank from its starting square. When the pawn reaches the last rank, it gets a promotion. You can trade your pawn for a queen, knight, rook, or a bishop. It is allowed to promote multiple pawns to get multiple promotions. Let us now look at the queen. Queen is the most powerful piece in chess. It can move in any direction and also as farthest as possible. It can capture any enemy piece which gets in her path, except the enemy king. With such a great power, there is a limitation, that it cannot jump over other pieces. Here come the bishops. We get two bishops in the game of chess, a light squared bishop and a dark squared bishop. The bishops can only move diagonally and cannot jump over other pieces. The light squared bishop can only move to the light squares. The dark squared bishop can only move to the dark squares. The most interesting facts of the bishop are they never block each other and hence they make a good team. Let us now welcome the knight. This is a very interesting piece in chess. It moves in strange L shape. This is the only piece in chess which can jump over other pieces. I have highlighted all the squares where the knight can move on the next turn. It takes a little practice to understand how the knight moves. I will give a small tip to remember how the knight moves. From the square where the knight is, count 2 and then if you want to go to the left or to the right. 1, 2, left or 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 right. After the queen, the rook is the second most powerful piece in chess. The rook can move in 4 directions. Up, down, left or right. It can move as farthest as possible. The rook cannot jump over other pieces. An important point to remember, the rook belongs on open files. Finally, let's meet the most important piece of the game, the king. Even though the king is most important piece in the game, it isn't the most powerful. It can move one square at a time in any direction. I have highlighted all the possible squares the king can move on the next move. Let us now learn some fun rules like castling. Castling is the only move where two pieces move at once. In castling, the king moves two squares on the either side and the rook moves to the other side. The side with the gap of two squares between the king and the rook is called as short castle. The side with the gap of three squares between the king and the rook is called as long castle. Remember, castling can only be done if the below requirements are met. Point number 1. There should be no pieces in between the king and the rook. Point number 2. The king or the rook on the side of castling shouldn't have moved before. It should be the first move for both the pieces. As you can see, the rook on A1 has moved to C1. Hence, the legal castle can be only done on the short side. Point number 3. Castling is not allowed through a check or if the king will land in a check. Now that we have learned how the pieces move, let us now understand what are the possible outcomes of playing chess. In a game of chess, either you can win, lose or draw the game. Let us see how the games are drawn. Point number 1. Agree to a draw. This happens when neither player sees a way to victory. Point number 2. If the exact same position is repeated 3 times. As you can see on the screen, we have seen this position for the first time. This is for the second time. The third time and the game is drawn. Point number 3. A game is drawn when neither player has enough pieces to checkmate. Point number 4. You can also draw if 50 moves are played on the board without any captures or pawn move. To win a game of chess, you need to understand what is check and checkmate. Check means when a piece is threatening to capture the king on the next move. You need to first deal with the check in order to continue the game. As you can see on the board, the white rook is threatening to capture enemy king on the next move. You cannot ignore the check and play another move while leaving your king in check. There are three ways in which you can get out of check. First, by moving your king to the square where it is no longer in check. Another way is to block the check with other piece. Oftentimes, the best way to get out of check is to capture the checking piece. Finally, a checkmate means when the king is in check and it cannot escape the check by moving, blocking, or capturing. That means you win. Checkmate.